Love one.
A lot of people will talk about that World Championship final that they played in November of 21. Which you were at, Adam, in front of Dong that day. 4-0, won it very comfortably.
Yeah, not many on the level. Ma Long wasn't there, despite having three consecutive World Championships before that. The defending champion wasn't there. Been a long time since anyone's won four in a row. This just after winning the Olympics, by the way. Yeah. Still a bit of a head scratcher for many.
2-all.
Yeah, that's the one thing really missing for Fan Zhengdong, the Olympic gold.
Oh, well, he's changed the pace a bit. I mean, you can see him with a really closed racket. That's a bit more reaction. It was just a little bit late there because he was pinned. Fan Zhengdong puts on the pressure right in that crossover point. That's the elbow of the opponent's arm holding the racket.
So he was cracked a little bit there to play it, wasn't he?
That's exactly right. Forced into a decision. There's a little bit of indecision here. Bit of fortune for Fan Zhengdong off the top of the net.
Two five.
I asked you prior to the start of this, just off air, did you think this was going to be one of the closer ones? And you
no.
Said no.
No, I don't think so.
Six,
I hope so.
Two.
Right.
I'd love to see it come down to the seven.
Right.
The last time they played, I don't know. I mean, it just was a bit one-sided. Truls Morgaard is a very tricky player. He was shut down.
7-2.
And that's one of those tricks that, I mean, a lot of people have trouble hanging with, but the explosive power in the legs of Xiaopeng. Watch Fan Zhengdong leap for that, and he's already back. Half of people, even pros, would have been running towards the barriers after that.
2-8.
Already 6 points clear of his opponent, Fan Zhengdong.
2-9.
I actually say that just to motivate Truls.
9.
Nice shot block here. So interesting. We have so many different pronunciations of the word three here. I like it. Good variety. Just like the spin off of the backhand of Truls Morgaard.
9-4.
Well, that's probably the best shot he's played in this first game.
He approaches every shot differently. I had a chance to ask him in Sweden years ago, actually on behalf of the fans for Ask a Pro Anything, your grip. What about that grip? He holds it differently than everybody else with his third finger high on the back of the racket.
4-10.
I mean, the racket itself is obviously a talking point as well, which we've discussed before. Fan Zhengdong with 6 game points.
Simply everything he does is different, but it's not bothering Fan Zhengdong right now.
Not at all.
5-10.
Not much anyway. 5 times it has.
10-6.
Nicely done there, Truls Morgaard.
10-6. Like that serve. Sort of jabs at it with light underspin, hoping for a slightly popped up shot. Quick step around to follow.
11-6. Game to 5.
Fan Zhengdong.
1-love.
Start off the serve there for Morgaard.
2.
Two, very good for Morgaard.
Love three.
Great work. We talked about that back brace. Phantom Dong is won 7 hours on court.
One.
He does have one of the most physical games of anybody I've seen over the years. Countless times he's near the ground. So low. Jules Morgaard has done a good job so far using his creativity here.
Reminder that he played Phantom Dong in the men's double semifinal at the start of the evening. Morgaard's also been playing quite a bit, over 6 hours now. That's great power from Morgaard.
Nice hand cuffing serve and a quick turn to follow it from the backhand corner. Interesting. Very rare that you see a receive like that from Fang Zhendong. Normally he'll dig in and try to load it with spin. Play it somewhere a bit uncomfortable.
3-4.
I think it's the right idea to find calibration, I'd say, and calculation for that matter, to think how much topspin do I need and how fast can I hit this ball early in the rally. Still a 1-point lead for the vice champion, Trules.
5-3.
Did you say that nickname came from that championship, world championship final?
Yeah,
I think. Vice champion?
Also his Instagram. His Instagram says vice champion, which is great. It's a good thing to have.
He's taken on board, isn't he?
Yeah. Well, he started it.
5-4.
Yeah, he'll put that away. Fans are done. Time to get.
It's a good length on the push before. He got Trules to play a more passive shot from the baseline. Trules knows he's not going to be able to do that.
5-all.
Even though this misses, there's clear intention. He gets himself a shot. Picking his spots on the table. Worked well for Zhang Ruey. Yang Xiaoxin did a good job with this tactic as well. Again, the underdog does have to take some chances. Either way, they're dead even. They've split the points so far.
5-6.
Oh, plays a great shot there, Trules Morgaard, to repel the attacks of Phantom Dong.
Beautiful chop block, side swipe, and then the punch with the backhand as well. The natural side spin on that chop block will carry the ball that way. Chop block again, but
yeah,
this time. Yeah, I'd love to see that again. I mean, just jabbed at it, and the rotation looked like there was almost no underspin on it. Straight side, maybe even a little bit of top. I mean, that's just incredibly unusual.
Eight, five.
That lead increased to 3.
Variety of chop blocks. It is chop block central out here right now from Trules Morgaard. Just chop blocking it like a guillotine out here. And then follows. You get passive shots. Fang Zhendong hasn't found an answer yet to that chop block. The quality.
5-10.
5 game points here for Trules Morgaard. Wow.
11-5.
That is an incredible game. Chop block again. He's continuing. Why wouldn't you when you've just beaten Fans of Dong?
And the flick to start it off, sending him out. Wow. I don't think we have a chop block stat right now.
I'll tell you, there's a lot.
I will agree.
Chop block party at the moment. Which was Morgaard.
That was actually the name of my dubstep group in high school.
Well, he got well under the table. Phantom Dong was lurking.
Yeah, he's got incredible. incredible feeling, Truls Morgaard. Nice net recovery. I think the best we've ever seen from that position was Fan Zhendong himself.
Two all.
Yeah, there's sort of a... I'm just going to let loose here. I'm just going to play my shots. Be proactive from Truls Morgaard, as you said.
He's one of the few non-Chinese players that plays a full arm stroke so well.
Clean two.
This one right at the baseline, loaded with spin and speed. Watch the quality of the shot. Shot block just a moment late there. If it comes down, it's going to be trouble.
Three all.
Punished, spanked.
How good was that?
Well, a just incredible receive. Not the first time we've seen it. Wow, as baseline as can be. He's taking his chances. He's looking for short rallies. And fair, again, it's the law of averages. When you are the underdog, you must play bold.
4-3.
Yeah, he is really in a really good place at the moment, isn't Truls Morgaard?
He's got a wide variety of skill sets. Feeling is one of those, obviously, like we see in the chop block and the touch game. But the flat hits, the punches, the full-on swings. Little warning here not to stall for Fan Zhendong.
Four, five.
Oh, he knows it. He was close.
I love it. Chops. I mean, this is an incredibly unusual skill to see. Fan Zhendong had one of the best chops we had seen with heavy side spin not too long ago. Truls, again, capable of anything, turns around. Ooh, could have come down. It's okay, says Jorgen Persson from the bench. 91 men's world champion in singles.
6-4.
Right now, Truls Morgaard has been delighted how things are panning out.
In all fairness, with the predictions and whatnot, we have to remember Fan Zhendong was beaten early. The first round last week in Goa, maybe a little over a week ago, by Cho Dae-sung.
6-5.
A lot of table to aim at there for Fan Zhendong.
I only bring that up because while Cho Dae-sung is really strong, Truls, one of the best in the world, got a bag full of tricks to go with it.
There's two events in a row.
6-4.
Fan Zhendong was out in the opening round, which is highly unusual.
Wouldn't expect that from a man 3,000 plus points above the world number two.
That happens to be Ma Long.
Right, yeah. Towering over the greatest of all time.
Six, seven.
He's fearless at the moment, isn't he? Truls Morgaard.
He's very clear on his tactic, and I think that fearless applies. But he's definitely determined and focused as well.
Bit of mumbling going on there, Fan Zhendong.
Seven all.
Different determination here from Fan Zhendong, the amount of energy he put into that shot to really keep the pressure on. Again, table height, had to come across the chest for that ball to make it just as spinny as he wanted, while still not taking too long, keeping Truls in the corner.
Eight,
brilliant stuff. He had to withstand all that, Truls Morgaard.
I've seen Truls try lobbing twice so far on the TV table, and neither of them, to my memory, came down. One save, volunteers. That sky lob, racket already turned around. Fan Zhendong puts the red side on the forehand because he doesn't need spin when it's that high. He needs speed.
Eight all.
It's very unusual. The only time I can recall seeing Fan Zhendong lob down was against Xuxin, where he hit the table with his racket and it flew to the barriers behind him. It's the only time I can recall seeing him lobbed down. Again, even here. Last time they were at 5-5 in the last game, it was a runaway train for Truls.
Eight, nine.
We've seen that three or four times now from Truls Morgaard.
I mean, he's really looking to get in wherever he can. It's inside the table. This is a page out of the Ma Long book, the autobiography. When did he have time to write that?
Ten, eight.
Two game points for Truls Mogård to go 2-1 up. What is going on?
The first time I've seen a slow shot from Truls, a change of pace, really being effective. I think coming after all the heat that he's brought in this game, it caught Fang Zhendong completely off guard.
He's done it. Truls Mogård is in front here.
But the third tournament in a row, the first event in a row.
One love.
I did it. I finally stepped in it. Good times, good times. Mogård continuing to start strong here.
There was the cup finals. Dmitry Ovtcharov in the first round, then Zhou Daesong in the star contender.
One all.
In Goa. By the way, he was two up in that one, Fang Zhendong against Zhou.
Wow. Right here, 2-1 up. Second time the chop hasn't come down. We'll see when he's back there. The lob worked last time. Good length on this one from Fang Zhendong. The back of the table in the way.
Fang there. Much more vocal now.
These are the shots, right, that have come down last game in crucial moments. Almost an around the net. Oh, yeah. Just a reminder, you do not have to go over the net. Fang Zhendong has demonstrated that on many occasions. Doesn't miss by a lot. Mm. Very low percentage shot, though.
Five,
two, three.
I like the idea. Deep to the backhand, right back down the line.
If that had got over, that would have been the point, you would have thought.
Taste of his own medicine. Yeah. This is what half long is all about, leaving it inside the table, the shorter side of half long. When you start to feel that someone's predetermined their receive, it gives you this advantage that you can give them something that you think would be uncomfortable for them to, you know, really carry out their plan. Seen him go even longer. Fang Zhendong with heavy spin there. Good save. Pressure, a bit of side spin. I think Truls thought there was a little bit more on it. So the ball would have curved back if there was more side spin. Only nine, but a long distance from behind the table. In all fairness, in this match, nine is a long rally. And it's technically, for our statistics, anything more than eight is a long rally. It was just that Han Ying before had some really long rallies, as choppers do. Chop is going to chop. Four apiece here. This could be crucial for Fang Zhendong.
4-5.
Just in front here, Fang. Not yet able to take a firm grip on this game. Fun.
It's so unusual to see this. Good thing she brought her power bank.
Five, six.
I like this. He gets there early so that he can hold position. He really holds his racket out there and waits to see what Fang Zhendong wants. And now a timeout on Fang Zhendong's side.
So close.
You could see that he knows he can make this shot. Scooping it up from near the ground as wide as can be, goes for a flat hit. Nice save there. It was an awkward ball, a little bit off the net, no problem. And one more. Fang Zhendong leaves the whole table open. And just so much power. He did a dolphin jump. Did you see that? Both feet forward. I love it. Big point there out of the timeout from Fan Zhendong.
6-7.
And a big shot as well.
More vocal than we've heard in some time. He's going to be quite pumped here, especially after the last two events he's played. Good surprise factor. Trules caught like a deer in headlights.
These rallies are of such supreme quality. But Fan Zhendong, 3 points in a row.
Took a lot of muscle there to even get the forehand in. And then the save again. That second to last shot from Trules was truly incredible. But Fan Zhendong is so dialed in right now. He's going to expect everything back. You can't really expect what is coming back or how it's coming back. Yeah. But you will expect it to come back.
Beautiful, exquisite from Fan Zhendong. What a timeout. What it's been for him since then.
Four straight points, and this is the best answer we've seen to a chop block from Fan Zhendong in some time. Perfect touch with Trules posed like a statue on the other side. It's almost like the pose we see after a winning.
A winning, yeah.
That's right, a win there from him.
Seven, nine.
Good use of the change of pace here, slowing it down when Fan Zhendong is way behind the table. That's the time to do it. And it wasn't high. He kept it low, soft, well disguised.
Important for him to break that run of points.
Eight, nine.
If.
Go on.
Trules takes this game. Not only is he 3-1 up, his opponent doesn't have a timeout, and he does. If he doesn't, they're tied up. Trules still has his timeout. Momentum, in theory, would be with Fan Zhendong.
10-8.
2 game points for Fan.
Very well played by the world number one to hit that short side with power. It's tough to get it past Trules in this regard. This Beauregard right there, the deep, deep corner. An extended racket only, maybe.
Ten, nine.
Still some fun in this game. Juice. Trules Beauregard, excellent from him. This is just within the last 5 minutes how this has swung both ways.
It's almost dizzying. This has been a roller coaster of a match. Entertaining to watch no matter what when Trules plays, but the score line in this was completely. Completely that. Where did that come from? For the second time in the last handful of points, Trules has been on the backhand corner. Fan Zhendong going as risky as can be and just a rail slide of a skate shot there to the edge. And it sets up game point for Fan Zhendong.
12-10.
Went for it. Fan Zhendong has leveled things here. Just don't know what's going to happen next in this match. That's been the beauty of it.
One block.
Still not an easy ball, but well set up by Fan Zhendong.
You just see how he was looking to take the pace off.
and then suddenly accelerated again to his mobile.
I love points like this. I always feel like I just imagine it in a different sport, and I imagine the gloves up and someone's swinging as hard as they can, and he's just blocking, 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 and then a tap in the right place and it's over.
18 shots at one.
18.
18.
Sure didn't feel like it. I guess four on each side felt pretty quick. But accelerating here from the forehand, gets himself a ball that misses high enough that he can catch it at eye height.
I mean, the sheer battling for each and every point now.
Still the early parts of this game, but all I can hear in my head is, oh, it's just so intense.
Almost dismissive in the back end there, Morgaard.
He hit an inside-out forehand, brushing as low as can be. This angle is going to be perfect. Check this out. Full arm extension. The fact that Fan Zhendong was able to block it at all or touch it is pretty crazy, but he had to reach completely across his body. You need more than a back brace to help you from that one.
Got it! Four, three.
He did well to even get that back, Morgaard.
Yeah, Fan Zhendong taking control from the early part. Nice long push, creates an opening. He's got a free forehand there, uses his backhand from the forehand side.
Another high, high quality for Raleigh.
He was in the air for two shots. Jules Morgaard punching it back. This is one where we have to see the replay. On the move, ripping backhand, step around forehand. As he was moving the other way, he jumped. Did you see what his right elbow did? How he can even keep track of which way his racket is facing is beyond me.
Again, so close to getting that over.
And the thing is, when he gets these shots over, they're so unconventional that it's a lot of work for Fan Zhendong. These aren't balls you practice against. How could you? I mean, playing lots of matches, it happens from time to time, occasionally maybe.
But how consistently is he trying to play those chop blocks as well?
Chop blocks, flat hits, rushing shots, whatever it takes. When Fan Zhendong's on the other side of the table, sometimes you just have to keep the racket high and improvise. That's what he's been doing quite well when he gets pushed behind the table. Evened out here, five apiece.
6-5.
Yeah. The fact that Fan Zhendong has not seemingly completely got to grips with what's being played by Jules Morgaard at the moment just makes this so intriguing, so compelling to watch.
6-all.
I think on the fourth try, he got it, actually. Can understand that frustration. Now, in terms of the shape of the racket, you have to wonder.
Oh, if it was normal, you mean?
Right, if it was rounder, there might have been slightly more extension in that exact place where he hit it.
Got it. 7-6.
Did you say he debuted it at the World Championships?
Well, it was quite a starring performance then. I feel like he'd only... Yeah, I think so. I think he was one of three players holding it at the World Championships, but he was the vice champion. He was the reason it was sold out around the world. Anyone you see using that racket anywhere in the world, someone goes, what up, Trules? Nice to see you, Trules. They know.
Six, eight.
Yeah, about a bigger lead as we've had in this fifth game. 2 points. That's how tight it's been.
The power on that backhand. Good response to a slightly more lackadaisical shot, something a little bit rhythm breaking.
Yeah, incredible. Six of the last eight has been fun. It didn't feel like it.
Yeah, that is pretty crazy. I think it's partially because Morgaard's been contesting and we've had some longer rallies.
Yeah. Well, if he wants to stay in this game, Morgaard has to make the move now.
10-6.
Four game points. Van den Donk.
The use of side and topspin there as he leans and then the bending backhand. Just a bit wide for the table. Four game points for the world number one. And regardless, I think what you're saying is, regardless of who wins, a game seven would sure be worth the wait.
One love.
And that means that Truls Morgaard has to win this one to take us to that seventh.
Absolutely demoralizing. Talk about taking the wind out of your sails. Look at the crowd on this one. Chop block low, perfect shot. And he just extends his arm and plays it right back on the line.
That might be his biggest celebration yet. It's going to sting a bit, doesn't it, for Truls Morgaard?
Funny, for a minute I thought he was calling a timeout.
Yeah,
the hand signal is very similar.
It looked like that.
Again with the shape of the racket, just feeling that top flat edge. Bit of frustration as you mentioned, but still has to stay focused.
Oh, he's really stretched himself in that one, isn't he?
I watch with this incredible awe that he's not injured. I'm thankful he's not. It seems like the type of thing that could have hurt, but just mostly a reaction after. See the real quads there from that position.
Got in place with the backhand.
It's interesting how different their physiques are when you think about it. Considering the muscles that are the most important in table tennis, the Truls Morgaard's giving him a real run for his money.
Moving Morgaard around in that rally, Van den Donk.
Every time he touches the ball, it's something a little bit different. The backhand's in this rally. I mean, his arm is just moving in a different way. He comes into it. It's not a predictable rotation. It's impressive that Van den Donk is able to rally with him the way he has.
The table, he took it.
Seemed right about table height. You're possibly right. I mean, this chop block. So that one under the table, chop block. Next one, good response. Yeah. Doesn't wait for it to get too low. Truls Morgaard says, "Okay."
Yeah, that's pretty decent.
Gives him the Elvis lip, out of respect.
Three, five. Timeout.
Increase to three.
Step right out of your timeout. 12 out of the last 16 points for Van den Donk, and the timeout hasn't changed yet.
6-4.
Let or no?
No, he's got the point.
Wow. Oh, he served it off the edge.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, that was the acknowledgement of the forge. I was like, huh. Bit of a break here in a crucial moment for Truls Morgaard.
Two slices of luck for him in a row.
A lot of slices left, we'll see. Although, to be fair, I mean, most of it hasn't had anything to do with luck so far. He's earned a significant, I mean, two games, a whole lot of points. 1-point game now.
He's dragged himself right there. He's level.
The way he digs in for these receives, right off the bounce, such precision, and then a flat sort of flick there, a little punching backhand, just guides it. So unusual. Creativity, you and I were talking about that a lot earlier in a different sense, but it's so handsomely rewarded out here.
Six, seven.
Well, Fine would be happy that he stopped that little run of Morgaard's.
Yeah, three in a row for Truls Morgaard before Fong Jindong was able to capture another.
Eight, six.
Brilliant from Fong Jindong.
Reaction time here to not only be in position, but to bring it back perfectly to the middle. It's an uncomfortable ball. Fong Jindong survives quite a heated attack there.
Giving up without a fight, Truls Morgaard.
He's channeling his inner Adriana Diaz. Backhand punch, soft one, and one more backhand punch. They have a lot of similarities in their game, interestingly enough, and have been good friends for a long time. Calculated shot. I mean, this is really the type of shot that you feel like beginners would try and realize I've got to quit it because it's just too unsuccessful, too unreliable. But he's made it multiple times this match, last few points.
Got it! 8-9.
Well, he pulls that one out. Fong Jindong.
That's an excellent shot, and it's not the first time he's exploited that forehand line. Watch him come in here. Chiquita, the fact that he can twist that far and still play as wide to the forehand.
9-all.
Third towel break this game. This match is already night and day different than the last time we saw them play at the World Championships Finals. About a year and a half ago.
Well, this is a match worthy of a final, isn't it, right now? It's got that. It's got the flair, it's got the excitement. It's been fantastic to watch.
Ooh. Crucial point.
9-10.
Truls Morgaard has a game point to make this 3-all and go into a 7th.
What's Fong Jindong going to bring here? How does the world number one respond in this sort of situation? Staying calm on the other side. Truls could have shown some frustration, but just tucks in his shirt for a moment, it seemed. Maybe messed around with the waistband. That punch comes down. We're in game 7. Seems like it anyway. But here we are, alternating serves until one player has a 2-point lead.
11-10.
Every shot in that rally after the serve had a net involved. And it is now match point for the world number one.
Yep, his first one.
It was over in my head, yeah. But not for Truls. But that receive, still, he found a way to get up on one foot and slap it back. Arm swing completely behind just to get it out of the way after the shot. Saves match point, tied up again.
direction he wanted. Second match point for Fun Zendong.
A beautiful rally nonetheless. Fighting all over, counter looping, staying aggressive. You can see the smiles on the fans in the crowd. His fan club, just like his quads. Huge and well-defined.
Well,
we have been treated to a spectacular match here.